work through that cruise trim. Okay, let's see how fast you can go whilst keeping us level here. I think you can probably get up to about 80 knots without descending too much, so just hold it there. The nose is going to try and push back against you, so you can push it back again. So you hold that attitude, and then you give it a second or two and then verify. Yep, there's my 80 knot. That's about an 80 knot attitude, nose down attitude. Got a little bit of a descent coming in, so I can pull up another inch or so on my manifold pressure. As I pull up on the collective, it's going to try and push my nose off up, which will bleed off my speed. So I've got to counter that with a little bit more forward pressure on the cyclic. There you go. So I say we are about 80 knots. Do you feel like you're having to put a little bit of forward right pressure as well as forward? There's a little bit of right to compensate for this.
Yeah, I kind of feel that.
So keep on the controls. I'm going to stay to the right-hand side of that road because we don't want to fly over these houses.
Okay.
I'm going to pull the cruise trim up, okay? And I'm going to show you how it feels different on how the pressures. It kind of takes away some of that right pressure you're having to put in at forward, high forward airspeed. So maintain at least 80 knots. The cyclic's going to feel like suddenly it's going to feel a little bit different where it centers, but... Okay, so identifying cruise trim and pulling cruise trim.
Ooh.
Kind of feels weird. All right, fly around with this for a minute. See how it feels a little bit different. Kind of feels like you're not having to do this.
Feels good though.
So a couple of things about the cruise trim. Three things about the cruise trim. One is if you're ever going to pull it, make sure you always reach around the left-hand side. If you reach around the right, there's just more chance that you'll accidentally pull our mixture.
Uh-huh.
Second thing is always identify it before you pull it. It's that round-topped one, so put your hand on it. Okay, I got cruise trim, pulling cruise trim. And the third thing is, if we're going to use it, we really got to make sure that we check that it's down when we come into land. It's a very strange experience trying to hop. You can do it, but it's kind of really strange. Let's head actually this way over here. We'll stay away from this housing area. Clear that. So as we approach a runway, one of our landing checks will be cruise trim is down when we first come in from flying with a cruise trim on. But another thing is there's a little knob on the left-hand side of this console. It's about that big that rotates. That changes how much pressure it puts in and out. I'm going to put the cruise trim back down, so you're going to get a slight left jolt. Identifying cruise trim and down. All right.